Hey everyone, it's Steve from stevezanella.com. How are you today? I wanted to come here and talk to you today about dealing with doubters, haters, and trolls. What do you do? They're everywhere. How do you deal with it? We'll talk about that next. Everyone, if you haven't already, do me a favor, hit that subscribe button and click that little bell icon. That way you'll get a notification every time I post a new video. You may be wondering why I'm in the car. I've been doing a lot of thinking about trying to get more consistent with videos, and one of the things that I'm realizing is I personally get too wrapped up in trying to make things too perfect. I'd love to be in my office where I have a nice setting and I can control lights and sound and things like that, but I have three kids, I have a very busy life, and the house is never quiet. So trying to find time to create a video is challenging because there's never a really nice window of opportunity for me to sit down and record my thoughts without getting interrupted or having a lot of loud noises in the background. And I used to make videos driving in the car on my way into work or on my way home. Hello everyone, Steve from stevezanella.com. How are you? How are you today? How are you today? How are you today? Stepped all over that, but how are you? A lot of comments about people thinking it's not very safe. So I'm really trying to get back in the habit of making videos more often. And one of the ways that I find that it's easiest is to just, when I get in the morning after I drop the kids off before I go into work, just kind of do a quick video in the car. So that's why I'm here.
All right, I don't feel like I explained that very well. Sorry to interrupt myself, but I don't have a lot of time to do videos at home. So that's why I always did them in my car, and I always did them driving. But I got a lot of negative feedback, people feeling like it wasn't very safe to do. So I'm trying to be respectful of that, but I'm also trying to balance how I can do more videos. And since I can't really do them driving in the car anymore, what I decided to do is to park the car and to do the video in the car, but not driving. So that's why I'm in the car and I'm not driving, because I'm trying to find time to do videos when I don't have a lot of time or a lot of quiet time. So just trying to explain it a little bit better than I did in the car, but may have made things worse, I'm not sure. But anyway, back to me.
In this setting, it's not perfect, but you know what? What do they say? Good is the enemy of great, or great is the enemy of good? Something like that. I'm not sure. But essentially, it's no more excuses. You do what you can do, you make the best of it, and you move forward, and that's what I'm doing. So, I want to talk to you today about haters, doubters, and trolls. As my videos have been getting more likes and views, I'm getting a lot more comments, and I've been getting a lot more trolls and a lot more negative feedback. And I love constructive criticism. I love getting feedback on the things that I do in my you know, day job, my daily life. I'm a designer, and I work with a lot of people to design things for them personally and for their business, and that requires me being able to take criticism and feedback. But there's a difference between constructive criticism and negativity and trolls and haters. There are a lot of people out there who simply love to criticize and doubt and tell you you can't do things. I'm sure if you're watching this, somewhere along the way you've wanted to do something with your life and someone told you you couldn't or you shouldn't. They doubted you. They told you you didn't have the ability. Maybe you weren't smart enough. Maybe you weren't talented enough. Maybe you were too lazy. Maybe you were not motivated enough. Whatever it is that they said to you, I want you to understand something. If you are passionate about doing something, if you want to create something, if you want to build something, there is always going to be someone who tells you you can't. Always. But the most important person to have in your corner that believes in you, that knows you can achieve it, that knows it's gonna be hard work, but is gonna continue to push forward. Your biggest fan needs to be you. You need to figure out how to be confident enough to push through all the hate, all the negativity, all the trolls. Push through it because it's always going to be there. I guarantee you, any person who has ever built or created anything new has dealt with people telling them that they can't or they shouldn't. The reason why there are always so many doubters and so many haters is because it is far easier to look at something that someone is doing and find fault in it than it is to actually build something yourself, to create something. If you look at a painter, it is far easier for someone to look at a painting and say what's wrong with it or what they don't like about it than it is for someone to sit down at a blank canvas with paints and a paintbrush and paint something themselves. When you create something, when you put something out there, you're allowing yourself to be vulnerable. You're opening yourself up for people to comment and to say things. It is part of the process. What you need to do is learn to understand that it is easier for someone to pick something apart than it is for them to build it. And many people are threatened by the success of others because it highlights the things that they're not doing. They've never taken the chance. They've never tried to create something. Therefore, when they see someone else doing it, there's a bit of that sort of ego in them that wants to tear it down, that wants to say, well, they're not really that good, or it's not really that great, or what they're doing really, they're not doing it well, or I could do it better, but I just don't want to or don't have the time. When you're a creator, you have to understand that that comes with the territory, that you need to push through that and continue to do what you want to do because you have passion for it and you believe there's something bigger behind it. I do these videos because I'm passionate about trying to help people. I struggled with anxiety and panic attacks for the majority of my life, and it had such a negative impact on the things that I did and the person that I was. When I finally came through the other side, figured some things out, figured out what tools worked, and started to put my life back together, I am passionate about sharing my journey with other people because I know how impactful it was on me, and I want to try to help other people as well. So that's what I have to keep in mind every time someone gives me negative feedback on a video or tells me something isn't good or I shouldn't be doing something. I have to remember that it's always easiest to tear someone down than to build yourself up. I have to remind myself of that because it's hard. It's hard to put passion and heart and soul into something and put it out there into the universe and have people come back and sort of poo-poo all over it. Poo-poo. It's not easy. It's not easy to take that criticism sometimes, especially when they're not trying to help you. A lot of these people are just trying to tear you down. A lot of their comments aren't even factual. They're not trying to see you improve. And that's the difference between constructive criticism and trolls and haters and doubters. If they really care about you, they're gonna try to help you. They're gonna try to encourage you and try to help you get better. And that's the difference. That's what you have to look for, because people who are trying to help you improve, those are good people to have. They support you, they love you, they care about you, and they're trying to help you get better at what you wanna do. Start to work on your mindset to become comfortable with that type of criticism, because it will come. Don't let it tear you down. Don't let it dissuade you or keep you from moving forward. That's one person's opinion. And we're always going to gravitate to the negative opinion because it reflects on us, and it usually hits something inside of us, an insecurity that we still need to work on. Don't let it dissuade you from doing the things that you want to do. Don't let them influence you. Stay the course, stay positive, keep creating. Influence your environment, don't let your environment influence you. Keep putting yourself out there. Keep growing, keep improving, and keep having a positive impact on the people around you. That's the way we're going to change the world. That's how we're going to improve our lives and the quality of lives of the people that we care about most. It's not always going to be easy, but it's always going to be worth it. So I hope this helps. Do me a favor. Write down in the comments section below, have you ever dealt with haters? How did you deal with it? What did they say? How did you move past it? I'd love to hear your story. Reach out, let's connect, let's touch base. I love hearing from you guys, you know that. All right, that's it for me. Until we talk again, and we will talk again, I hope you have an amazing day.